Yeah, so I think many people are surprised when they learn just how much NASA is involved in your life, right? And it's from things that you'd expect, like very high technology things, from everything that that we think of as sort of our part of our everyday life, you know, whether it's cell phones or GPS systems for navigation, emergency beacons that are all satellite-based, right? A lot of our weather forecasting and the tools that that are available to us to both for agriculture, for weather forecasting, for natural resources, are all space-based and are really all outgrowths of our space program. So those are the things that people tend to think of sort of when they first think of you know, what NASA is doing for you. There's some that are even more specific that maybe don't come to mind just as quickly. Some examples would be technologies that are developed for sensing and imaging and communication on orbit that find use in non-space applications. A good example would be CMOS sensors that are developed for space sensing that are, in fact, all the cell phone cameras, pretty much all the cell phone cameras in use today, that miniaturized CMOS sensor that we have all come to know and love and do selfies with, was developed originally for a NASA mission. And then even maybe even further from the hard technology are the things that we do that affect humans directly, right? So a lot of our mission, particularly in human spaceflight, deals with keeping humans safe and healthy in an austere environment, right? And those technologies have direct application to remote medicine on Earth, to nutrition. I'll give you a couple examples. We do a lot of work with remote miniaturized sensors that can be used on the International Space Station, for example, where the crew is, you know, days away from having access to medical facilities. So we necessarily have to have a lot of tools on board. And a lot of those have been translated through licensing to be used in medicine, particularly in remote locations or austere locations. One that I learned about recently that is even more surprising is that we do a lot of work with nutritional and health benefits for our folks that are on orbit for long periods of time, right? So they need nutritional supplements to help with, you know, bone loss and nutritional deficiencies and so on. And so we've developed some particular compounds that are now finding their way into like something like 90% of all the baby formula stuff in the United States contains supplements that were developed for NASA.